This is ghost. Ghost is not like a scary ghost. Ghost is an entity of the past. Ghost can be a memory, ghost can be a story. And I also have my own personal experience about ghosts. How you were brought up in this community. It's not really ghost, but it's more like an educational, more like a moral story rather than a spooky Halloween story.
The style, that's the most important thing. Why is it like this? Why is it not realistic? Why is it, I can't see any ghost there. I can't see the ghost, but ghostly. Can't you tell? And what do you call this style? This is an abstract, or is this a realism, or is this a representation, or non-representation? What is this style? If you ask me, I say, I don't know. This is halfly conscious, halfly subconscious. When you pay, if you watch the video when I was on the floor just last night, it's partly subconscious, partly rely on your intuition, partly rely on your movement on the canvas, how comfortable you move on the canvas, partly depending on the material that you use, whether it's slippery or it's a rough material. All has got to do with the process that contribute to these kind of images. And then you step back and look at it again. Oh, I can see some image. Then you start going to the tail. Oh, I can see some floating biological form. And then you go to the tail. So it's back and forth, without having any preconceived idea what it's going to be like. I think that's the most fun. I enjoy it greatly because I don't have this burdening responsibility of giving meaning. So this gave me such a freedom to explore, just to make painting based on my instinctive value, or my past experience, or my childhood memory, or my present moment. Totally new medium, totally new experience, totally new material. Never been used before. I find it techy because the only thing I use during the dark during the Halloween. And I paint my daughter's face for the Halloween party. That's it. And they come in a small tube. You squeeze one tube and then you paint. Now they gave me the whole powder. Actually it was made by powder. So I have to buy me a powder. And that you have to mix that powder to a certain amount with a primer. Primer is a glue. So it's a quite tedious process, but a very exciting process. So the whole studio, my studio, have to be fixed with a UV light in order to see it glow. It can glow without the UV, but it only lasts for 8 hours. If you have the UV, as long as you turn on the UV, it will glow.